This is the good news. The grave is empty. Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Alleluia.
This is the good news. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness shall not overcome it. Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Alleluia.
This is the good news. Once we were no people, now we are God's people. Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Alleluia.
This is the good news. Christ is our peace, the indestructible peace we now share with each other. Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Hear now this glorious resurrection story from John chapter 20, verses 1 through 18. Early on the first day of the week, while it was still dark, Mary Magdalene went to the tomb and saw that the stone had been removed from the entrance. So she came running to Simon Peter and the other disciple, the one Jesus loved, and said, "They have taken the Lord out of the tomb, and we don't know where they put him." So Peter and the other disciple started for the tomb. Both were running, but the other disciple outran Peter and reached the tomb first. He bent over and looked in at the strips of linen lying there, but did not go in. Then Simon Peter, who was behind him, arrived and went into the tomb. He saw the strips of linen lying there, as well as the burial cloth that had been around Jesus' head. The cloth was folded up by itself, separate from the linen. Finally, the other disciple, who had reached the tomb first, also went inside. He saw and believed. They still did not understand from Scripture that Jesus had to rise from the dead. Then the disciples went back to their homes, but Mary stood outside the tomb crying. As she wept, she bent over to look into the tomb and saw two angels in white seated where Jesus' body had been, one at the head and the other at the foot. They asked her, "Woman, why are you crying?" "They have taken my Lord away," she said, "and I don't know where they have put him." At this, she turned around and saw Jesus standing there, but she did not realize that it was Jesus. "Woman," he said, "why are you crying? Who is it you are looking for?" Thinking he was the gardener, she said, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have put him, and I will get him." Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned toward him and cried out in Aramaic, "Rabboni," which means teacher. Jesus said, "Do not hold on to me, for I have not yet returned to the Father. Go instead to my brothers and tell them, I am returning to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God." Mary Magdalene went to the disciples with the news, "I have seen the Lord." And she told them all he had said these things to her. These are the words of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Who taught the sun where to stand in the morning? Who told the ocean you can only come this far? Who showed the moon where to hide till evening? Whose words alone can catch a falling star? Well, I know my Redeemer lives. I know my Redeemer lives. All of creation testify. His life within me cries, I know my Redeemer lives. The very same God that spins things in orbit, he runs to the weary, the worn, and the weak. And the same gentle hands that hold me when I'm broken, they conquer death to bring me victory. Now I know my Redeemer lives. I know my Redeemer lives. Let all creation testify. Let this life within me cry. I know my Redeemer. He lives to take away my shame. And he lives forever, I'll proclaim. That the payment for my sin was the precious life he gave. But now he's alive and there's an empty grave. Now I know my Redeemer lives. I know my Redeemer lives. Let all creation testify. Let this life within me cry. I know my Redeemer
lives. Let's pray together. Please join us in the unison prayer for the morning.
Come, risen Lord, you who promised to be with us always, to the end of time, to the ends of the earth, come and find me. Lead me out of this tomb, out to a place of hope and healing, where the news is good and truth sets us free. and the whole world is full of possibility, where change can happen and will, and streets fill with laughter and banners proclaim, this is the first day of the rest of your life. Amen.
Blessing from Jan Richardson entitled Seen. You had not imagined that something so empty could fill you to overflowing.
And now you carry the knowledge like an awful treasure or like a child that roots itself beneath your heart.
How the emptiness will bear forth a new world that you cannot fathom, but on whose edge you stand.
So why do you linger? You have seen, and so you are already blessed. You have seen, and so you are the blessing.
There is no other word you need. There is simply to go and tell. There is simply to begin.